So as far as life goes, I think the only difference between humans and bacteria or any other form of life is a gradation. It's just a complexity. And you know, there are points where there's a big jump, obviously, from non-living to living. There are very few instances of something in between. A virus could be, you know, conceivably in between, or I guess you could say, but there are different steps of the evolution, but I think it's only an evolution, and I think it's only a complexity. And, you know, a bacteria moves towards things that it wants, like food, and moves away from things that it doesn't like that could eat it or cause it, you know, a wrong pH balance or something like that. It will move away from that. So they have some kind of perception at some very basic level. I would say some kind of, if you want to call it consciousness, I think we need to define our terms a little bit better, but some kind of proto-consciousness. And just like the Chinese said, you know, that present in mineral, it is alive in plants, it moves in animals, and it is self-aware in man. And I think they had that right. I think that that's what it is. It is only a level of complexity. And as if you, I didn't read Hoffman's book, but if from what I understand, he was saying there's the perception, something, and action, and these are conscious agents, supposedly. And when, if you have a PDA or whatever it is here, a conscious agent here and a conscious agent here, and they interact, it creates another. Well, that's emergence. You know, it creates some kind of overarching conscious agent that includes both of those conscious agents. So out of two becomes three. And, you know, the Hindus knew that out of two becomes three. And I believe the ancient Chinese probably as well. Might be confusing them with somebody else, but anyway, that is emergence. And I think that is just complexity. And there's also another problem I have is when you look at these, that perception and action on a level that's a quantum level or an atomic level or before somewhere before life to get to life, you have to define what perception and action actually mean. And I'm not sure how to do that. I don't know if we're there yet. You know, I hope Hoffman has a plan to do that. It would be interesting to see. But anyway, those are my thoughts on that.